Are you familiar with Area 51? You know, the spooky place that they have all the aliens and stuff in the United States? Well, Google for some reason decided to name something called Area 120, and probably didn't think I would make that joke about their app on the internet. So it's no secret for a while that I've complained that, you know, companies like Microsoft and Google haven't been able to make Notion or ClickUp alternatives, which makes no sense to me. Shout out Microsoft Loop for not existing and probably never existing. When I heard about Area 120, I was like, what the heck is this? They call it their in-house incubator. Let me look at the definition of incubator really quick. What? I don't know who thought that would be good landing page copy, but I was pretty positive it had to do with eggs or babies. I don't, Google, you're kind of on one right now. The whole reason for all this banter is because there's something about Area 120 that teases into this thing called tables, which makes me say, is this like a Notion or ClickUp alternative? Then I go to the bottom left and go, interesting. There's a sort of limitation to rows and tables and attachments and bot actions, which makes me think, yeah, it kind of is, especially with the whole workspaces thing. This is pretty unique. So if I go to the top left here, you can see I can start with a template, make a blank workspace. Let's just do a template just to see what they got. They got scrum boards, project management, Kanban board views, simple task trackers, project roadmap. They got a lot of stuff here that reminds me a little bit of those other applications. And I just didn't know this existed until recently. So let's get into an example table. Let's go to a project tracker here, get started. And I don't want to be tutorialed. I got this. So looking at this system, very basically, what I can tell is that this is a row group, which seems to be like a phase of this. Okay, so it's configured to group together that, and then this is a date property. This is very interesting to me. There's different tabs similar to what you got with like ClickUp and Notion. So let's go to this add column section and see what they got. Oh my God, they got text, number, date and time, person, which I'm sure is very easy to connect to something like, oh, as you can see here, let's discard this. Adding members, that's, yep, it'll add people that are in your context or within your organization. That's very convenient. And then going back here, drop down options. Yep, just like with the select property, tags, just like multi-select, checkbox. Also can give the default state, which is convenient. A checklist. Wow, that's like a nice set of subtasks. Example subtask one, example subtask two. Save. Oh, look at that. That's actually pretty. Yep, that's subtask within it. And then going below there, we have drive attachments. That's obviously convenient. That's obviously very convenient considering this is integrated with your system. Look at this. Wow. Okay. Yeah. Why are they not running with this and advertising it to the moon? All you got to do is have some basic sort of page layout functionality, and this thing would actually go nuts considering it'd be integrated with Google Drive. Everybody complains and Notion, like, hey, can you make, hey, you do consulting, can you make me like a Google Drive sort of synced between Notion and Google Drive? I'm like, why would you do that? Why would you? I mean, yeah, but kind of a pain. I'll do it, but I don't, I mean, now I know this exists. Maybe I'll just start consulting people on this if it looks better. I mean, going within this too, metadata columns, there's nice things like creator data, date time, comment time, row ID, link to table. Oh my God. This is just basically relations and lookups. Okay. If you add, let's do a discard here. You can add relationships, add a new lookup relationship from other tables. And then you can also do forms. So adding forms within there and even bots. So for example, you can remind people of things. You've reached the bot limit. So let's make a new bot because I'm very entertained by this automation. Column value changes. ETA. So when like a, that's really nice. It's basically like the button functionality you can see in Coda. So when, for example, if I, let's change this to income. Oh, let's change this to in progress. Let's say when these two are all checked off, maybe it switches status to complete. That'd be a cool bot. So when this new column, so you're gonna update the row, set column value to complete. So changes, column, new column, checklist, finish. Add this. Don't tell me this is actually gonna work. One, two, look at that. It automatically did that. Wow, see, this is stuff that Notion doesn't have. And I knew a company like Google would be able to make stuff like this. This is the kind of stuff that I just get flabbergasted why big companies don't realize the value that Notion has. Do you know what people are willing to pay for Notion workspaces nowadays? It's crazy. And then we look at time-based. You could add rows at certain times, which means you can make recurring tasks, obviously. You can update rows, you can delete rows, you can send webhooks, you can execute app scripts. This even integrates with app scripts from Google. Why is this not more popular? I just hit See, this is a problem when you have a huge nose and you record videos. This goes to the microphone. Shout out to Italians all over the place. Customize and send an email summary of the rows. I mean, this kind of stuff is actually very good. This looks gross, probably is gross. The instructions are laid out here too, which is very convenient when they give you this kind of stuff. You can control shift up and to the right and to the left, which you can't do in Notion, as if it was in Excel. You can group it by different things. Like for example, it's grouped by phase. I can cancel the grouping and bring it right back. You can filter it. I'm just going to spend this entire video being really excited about it. I'm going to make a video talking about whether Notion or this is better. And if you want to see more videos of me going nuts about how good apps like this can be, or you want to see more videos on Google Tables, let me know, because it's in beta, I guess. And when it comes out, I'm going to freak out. I'll freak out too if you check out this video right here.